watches that, like, they're expensive and they're nice because the nice ones rest on the shoulders as opposed to resting on the head like a pencil desk.
Yeah.
So it's free-floating.
Okay.
Which means that when you get knocked on the head, it's not direct contact with your head.
Seems good.
Yeah.
I can see the benefit of that.
That one. was not signed up. He came here and like he was on the waiting list. And he showed up and he went over to the table and was like, okay, are there any spots so I can like maybe like get in and or can I just sign a waiver and like record it? Like, yeah, that's fine. And then he went and did his gear check with Matt. And Matt's like, do you have all your stuff? And he's like, well, or do you have the same stuff you did last year? And Lars is like, so do you have like forearms and everything? He's like, I'm borrowing all the most. And he's like, all right, you're conditionally okay, but you gotta go get all that stuff. Every year, the community equips Lars with various bits of gear. Just things start to
line up or something.
Like, I think of it like stone soup. You know, you put a Lars into a fencing match, and we all contribute something.
Yeah, that's good. It'd be even better if it was good.
Lars got the hand hit, but he got it.
It's scrunchy.
Oh, yes. It's my long-standing beef with you guys' rule set. I understand the theory behind it.